General Salute! Present! Arms!
Well and truly serve our Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth II her heirs and successors. They will preserve the peace and tranquility of the said town, so far as in them lieth. And if they know of any unlawful conventicles or assemblies against the state thereof, they will forthwith dispose the same to the mayor of the said town, for the time being, whom they will aid to the best of their counsel and advice, and will defend the customs and privileges of this said town in every just and lawful cause.
Deputy Lord Lieutenant Colonel Cockerell, on behalf of the Chief Royal Engineer. Distinguished guests, all on parade, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. It is undoubtedly a real pleasure to welcome you all to the town of St Ives. It's my job today to answer one question. Why would we at St Ives wish to award its freedom to the Corps of Royal Engineers? Represented here most impressively by the 4-2 Engineer Regiment Geographic. Thankfully, I don't have to look any further than the statue before us of Cromwell. St Ives, it seems, likes to recognise fallen, complex heroes who have an impact at global scale. They are present and deployed, supporting many diverse activities around the globe. Through our host association, they will help put St Ives on the global map. From Cromwell, we can also think of the new model army, the way they innovated the development of a fighting force. For the first time, roles and responsibilities were based on skills and performance. So finally, what can St Ives provide the Corps? First and foremost, we can provide a welcoming, stable community where everybody and their families can thrive and hope and wind. Secondly, we can actively look to recruit and encourage those who join the reserves. I myself was once a reserve, admittedly with a blueberry. So to conclude, I'm convinced that before us we have a fine example of a new model army, and that for years to come, the Corps will exercise their freedom to march with bravery and pride through this historic town of St Ives as global heroes. So with that, I'm honoured and delighted to present to Colonel Cockerell on behalf of the Royal Engineer this freedom sword.
And with local schools and businesses. Of equal importance, the regiment has greatly benefited from the reciprocal friendship, trust and support that you, the residents of St Ives, have provided us. The regiment and the wider military community at RAF Witten hugely values such friendliness and goodwill. It means an enormous amount to us, knowing that our home base is a welcoming and safe environment. Mr Mayor, I am indeed most grateful to you and your fellow councillors for welcoming 40 Engineer Regiment Geographic into your community and for granting your town's freedom to the Corps of Royal Engineers. The exchange of ceremonial swords between the Royal Engineers and St Ives Town Council is a terrific way to mark this occasion, and I am absolutely delighted to be able to present the Mayor of St Ives, Councillor Tim Dry, with this sword, which is one of the pair, and as you've seen, the commanding officer now holds the other.
Engineer Regiment Geographic to fix bayonets and march through the streets of St Ives exercising their freedom.
Oh!